Will the Yankees ever learn from their mistakes? You know, the last ace the Yankees ever had was CC Sabathia in his prime. You can make the argument Severino has shown flashes of being an ace. They got him locked up to that extension. You know, he has room to show himself. He has room to prove himself to be an ace. But we're talking about 2019. We're talking about a 10-year drought that the Yankees haven't won a World Series. And we can't sugarcoat the moves or the moves that Brian Cashman hasn't made. Passing up on Cole. Passing up on Verlander for Sonny Gray. That was ridiculous, by the way. Corbin. Recently, Keuchel getting outbid for Keuchel. The New York Yankees getting outbid for players. That's unheard of. The Yankees absolutely have the chance to completely humiliate the Boston Red Sox. Obviously, if you peeped my previous video about 3 months ago, I stated that the Red Sox are going to suck this year. But at this point, the Red Sox, they're not a threat. Even if the Yankees don't go out there and get an ace. But you have to look at the Tampa Bay Rays. They're keeping up with the Yankees, and I don't see them slowing down. They could go out there and make some moves as well come trade deadline. Even the Twins, they're copying what the Oakland Athletics and the Yankees have done in recent years with the home run ball. They aren't the Twins that the Yankees beat up on. They're a different team now. We saw this when the Yankees faced off against the Twins at the stadium. I don't think it's a fluke. I think the Twins have caught fire, and it's going to last all season long. But the real team to look at in the American League is the Houston Astros. They're playing well. They have the pitching. And in my opinion, they're one move away for, let's say, being the number one contenders to winning it all. As of now, judging by the Yankees' rotation, sure, they could win the AL East, but it's not going to last come playoff time. The Yankees' rotation, in my opinion, it's subpar. Even wildcard teams like the Texas Rangers could beat this rotation. So before the Yankees make a boneheaded decision and make a trade for, like, say, a Stroman, who in my opinion is just going to be another Sonny Gray and going to become a free agent in 2021, I would prefer Marcus Stroman and another pitcher. Marcus Stroman and a certified household name ace. I'm talking about Bumgarner. Obviously, I would prefer Max Scherzer overall. Mad Bum, he's kind of, you know, in the middle. He could be an ace, and he could be subpar. You have to understand, Mad Bum has been pitching in the NL for his whole career. I don't know how he's going to do if, let's say, an AL team picks him up. So I give the front office and Brian Cashman this. They're great drafting international players. They're great making trades for players that nobody ever heard of. And all of a sudden, when they're Yankees, they're all-stars. I give them credit there. But where the Yankees are weak, ridiculously weak, is going out there and making a trade or signing for a certified ace. A pitcher that you know is going to bring you a World Series championship. That's all the Yankees need. That's all they needed for the last 10 years, or the last, let's say, 6 years, since CC has been on the decline. The last real ace that the Yankees ever had was CC Sabathia in his prime. I do not understand, with all of these opportunities that the Yankees have had to go out there and get a certified ace, we've seen them fall short. We know that's what they need, but they still won't do it. They still won't show the dollar signs. They still get outbid. They still take pitchers out to dinners, and they don't sign them. They're feeding their fan base one narrative that they are going to improve when it comes to the starting rotation, but they never do it. It's simple. You trade for a Max Scherzer who's going to become available, because if he doesn't get traded this season, they can't trade him anymore. He has something in his contract that says that. Another team might get Max Scherzer, and that team might be a team that's in contention and might be a threat for, let's say, the next 3 years. And I don't want to hear that Mad Max is old. He's owed too much money. Take Verlander as an example. He's in his, what, his third season, 2.5 years with the Houston Astros, and he's pitching like a Cy Young Award winner still. And you can make the argument that Mad Max is somewhat better than Verlander. I know the Yankees are all about saving money. Let's save money. Let's go out there and build a World Series caliber team with what we got. But while the fix is so easy that it only takes one player to make you World Series champions. And if you don't win it, at least you went out there and tried to get the best pitcher available. I'm not liking what I'm seeing from this Yankees rotation. Tanaka, like I stated in my previous video, is coming back down to earth. Paxton, you can make the case that he's an experiment. And Hap, he's a flip-flopper. You don't know what you're going to get from Hap this season. Hopefully, we see the Hap that the Yankees went out there and traded for. I mean, it's damn common sense to go out there and make a statement. Make a statement. 10-year drought, not winning the World Series. They only won one World Series in the last, what, 10, 20 years? 19 years, something like that? They are the New York Yankees. Stop operating like Bernie Madoff ripped your whole organization off. Something like that must have went down because the Yankees are cheap as hell right now. And they have been like that for the last 3 years. It is ridiculous. Make a statement. You only need one player. And if that player costs money, make it happen. Because if the Yankees get a Mad Max or maybe a Bumgarner and you sign him to extension, you are going to be World Series favorites for years to come. Period. We've seen it historically. A team goes out there and gets a certified ace. I'm talking about teams in contention. They go all the way to at least the World Series. And the funny thing is, the ball is in the Yankees' court all the time, but they don't pull the trigger. Wow. Yankees fans, leave your opinions in the comment section below. What do you guys think? Do you want the Yankees to override their philosophy of saving money and go for the jugular? Let's go out there and get an ace that's worth millions of dollars. Or let's just settle for, you know, a primitive Lance Lynn kind of picture. Leave your opinions in the comment section below. And like always, this has been Felix from NYNEWS.com. Share, like, and subscribe, and I will check you on next time. Before it hits the front page.